डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ अमाइड्स। अमाइड्स सिमिलर टू एस्टर्स, दे आर हाइड्रोलाइज्ड अंडर एसिडिक एज वेल एज बेसिक कंडीशन। सो अपॉन हाइड्रोलिसिस अमाइड्स दे आल्सो प्रोड्यूस कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स बिकॉज दीज आर व्हाट यू कॉल इट derivatives of carboxylic acid, and we know that under these conditions upon hydrolysis they give carboxylic acids. So and this hydrolysis of amides, they can be done under basic as well as acidic conditions, basic and acidic hydrolysis. So in the first reaction I have given you the example of acidic hydrolysis. Now let us see what happens under basic conditions. So under basic hydrolysis, let us see, if we have NaOH, then what we get is we get carboxylate anion. Sodium carboxylate plus ammonia is released. If we have some other amide, secondary amide, then we will get some amine. So this is your basic hydrolysis and this is your acidic hydrolysis. And we know that amides are most stable carboxylic acids. Amides are very stable. So we need very harsh conditions, very harsh acidic or basic conditions are required for hydrolysis. Usually in case of acidic conditions we require around 6 molar HCl, or we can use sulfuric acid also, and under basic condition you can say 40% NaOH. So these conditions are quite harsh. Now let us write some examples of basic as well as acidic hydrolysis. First let us see, then I will discuss with you the mechanism, and mechanism is quite similar to the hydrolysis of esters. So let me write any general example. RCONHR dash, it is your secondary amide plus NaOH in the presence of a base, and if we add water hydrolysis, what we get is, as I have told you, we will get sodium salt, carboxylate anion plus amine. Okay. Specific example we can write of this product, C double bond O N C 2 H 5 twice. So this is your NN dimethyl benzamide. NN diethyl benzamide. So it will give you, upon alkaline hydrolysis, first we will get sodium benzoate, COO negative, Na positive. So this is your sodium benzoate, and we will get a diethylamine, CH3CH2 twice NH, or C2H5 twice NH. So this is your basic hydrolysis. So under acidic hydrolysis, if I have to write example of acidic hydrolysis, then I will use same general example so that you can have some idea. Plus H3O positive acidic condition, so they will give you free carboxylic acids plus ammonium salts. Okay, R dash NH3 positive. We can write some specific example of N-methyl-2-phenylacetamide, CH2CONHCH3. This is your N-methyl-2-phenylacetamide. Okay, so plus sulfuric acid, you can use any mineral acid, presence of water, so we will get CH2COOH phenylacetic acid plus methyl ammonium sulfate, CH3NH3 positive, HSO4 negative. So this is methyl ammonium sulfate, this is phenylacetic acid, and this is N methyl 2 phenyl acetamide. Okay, so let us see the mechanism first. Let us see mechanism of basic hydrolysis. The mechanism is the same as that of hydrolysis of ester that we have discussed in our previous lecture of basic hydrolysis. The mechanisms are more or less exactly same. Let me write some amide R C double bond O NH2, any general amide. Now first step is addition of a nucleophile. We all know that first step is addition of nucleophile, and nucleophile is OH negative. It is quite strong, so it can easily attack here. Even though amides they are less reactive, but nucleophile being stronger, so first step is addition of nucleophile RCO negative OH. Next step, you all know that it will be elimination of leaving group. It is exactly the elimination of leaving group, exactly the same mechanism similar to esters. So this RCO negative OH NH2, this comes here, so this leaves. What we get carboxylic acid plus NH2 negative. So third step is proton transfer, similar to esters. So this is your proton transfer, that will be the next step. So RCO OH plus NH2 negative, it will obstruct a proton. RCOO negative plus ammonia, free ammonia is released plus carboxylate anion. So this is the mechanism under basic conditions. Now let us write mechanism of acidic hydrolysis. The mechanism is exactly similar to the acidic hydrolysis of esters. So the first step is acid catalyzed addition of a nucleophile. Nucleophile is water. So we will write here the first step is acid catalyzed addition of nucleophile, and nucleophile is water because amides they are very less reactive, so we need acid catalyst. So let us write C double bond O NH2. The first step is protonation. So protonation increases the electrophilic character of this carbon. So we get RC double bond OH positive NH2. So this is the resonance stabilized. You can show the resonating structures RCOH NH2 positive. So in the next step, now we can add water here, because you can either show here, it is up to you, any both are good. Show to this or to this. Now this carbon has increased electrophilic character, so water can add. So what we will get is that RCOH NH2 OH H positive. Next step is deprotonation to regenerate the acid. So this deprotonation, we can say loss of proton, loss of proton, it will give you the tetrahedral intermediate. Okay, NH2 OH. So this is our tetrahedral intermediate. So you can remember that this mechanism is exactly same as hydrolysis of esters. Now the next step is acid catalyzed, what we can say acid catalyzed elimination of leaving group. Okay, so let us see the mechanism how this leaving group departs R C O H O H N H 2. First step is protonation, then it will give you R C O H O H NH3 positive, so this is protonation. Then removal of this leaving group is facilitated by this step. You can show like this, that is the elimination of leaving group. So this is your elimination step, elimination. So what we get, RC OH positive OH plus ammonia. So next step is highly exothermic step. A proton transfer takes place. This comes here. This step is proton transfer. It is highly exothermic step. Proton transfer, and we get carboxylic acids plus ammonium salt. So this is the mechanism under acidic conditions. First, acid catalyzes addition of nucleophile, which is water. Then acid catalyzes elimination of the leaving group. So the mechanism is, as I have already told you, is exactly same as the mechanism of hydrolysis of esters. So that was all about the hydrolysis of esters, amides. So thank you very much for your kind attention.